fondest memories of growing up in New York include Russ and Daughters with my grandfather every single Sunday.
Russ and Daughters is the house that Herring built. There are four houses now. The original store on the Lower East Side, a cafe on Orchard Street, another one at the Jewish Museum, and the newest one, Russ and Daughters at Brooklyn Navy Yard.
We cross over to Brooklyn to meet up with Josh Russ Tupper of the fourth generation of Russ and Daughters.
So Russ and Daughters is in the fourth generation. So myself and my cousin, Nikki, own and operate all of our locations now. Our great-grandfather was Joel Russ, and he started the business. Before he started the store, he had a push cart on Orchard Street.
Oh my gosh, really?
And he ended up having three daughters and no sons. So another wonderful part of our history is he named the business Russ and Daughters.
Russ and Daughters at Brooklyn Navy Yard has the luxury of space where an open-plan bakery churns out what is probably one of New York's best bagels.
To make good bagels requires commitment. From forming the dough to proofing, refrigerating for a good 20 hours to boiling and baking. At Russ and Daughters, you're spoiled for choice. There's pumpernickel, cinnamon raisin, poppy, onion, garlic, and something fairly new, a pretzel bagel.
So I want to make you guys a sandwich.
Okay, looking forward.
Let's try a pretzel bagel.
Okay. Thank you.
My pleasure.
The bagel.
Yeah, nice, right?
And it's really not important. Just about the amount of salmon. You gotta taste the bagel, you gotta taste the cream cheese and just the right
amount. Salmon shouldn't overpower the cream cheese or the bread.
Exactly.
The capers or the onions.
Exactly.
Thank you.
Today, we've crossed over the Manhattan Bridge to the other New York borough, hip, charming, and trendy Brooklyn.
Missy Robbins, the chef behind Missy, has a long list of awards under her belt. Most recently, she was recognized as Best Chef New York City by the James Beard Foundation. But what really draws me to her is that, like me, she too found her Italian soul.
Missy in Williamsburg, Brooklyn is a celebration of handmade pasta dishes and vegetable antipasti inspired by simple Italian cooking. We start with slow roasted tomatoes and grilled baby artichokes.
Why don't you start with the artichokes?
I'll start with the artichokes.
Okay. Oh. Oh my God.
Really? Really?
It's like the taste of summer.
We chose tortelli filled with spinach and mascarpone with brown butter and ricotta salata.
The brown butter. All over that nice pasta with a lot of egg yolk. And the spinach and the mascarpone, it's so like smooth and refined.
That's the brown butter.
And then just a little cheese on top.
Then we had linguine with anchovy, garlic, parsley, and colatura. Something I've never encountered before.
Oh my.
I taste the patis.
Right? Colatura, I love it. It's like my new most favorite Italian ingredient.
Serving Southern comfort food since 2006, Pies and Thighs is a neighborhood restaurant with a cult following.
So this is a classic Southern recipe with cayenne, salt, sugar, paprika, black pepper. We've got the famous fried chicken, that's the thighs, and then we have delicious pies. We've got apple pie, banana cream pie. The pecan pie is not to be missed. Even if you're not a fan of pecan pie, it will make you a fan.
Whoa. Whoa.
Made better with smoked bacon, okay? Let's do this.
My first bite of Pies and Thighs.
You're so civilized, you're using a fork.
This doesn't seem like chicken.
Mm.
Oh. Look how tender it is, no?
Mm-hmm.
It falls apart in your mouth.
Seriously, it's really good.
No, I agree, totally.
Salty and sweet, light and crispy. I couldn't ask for anything other than a cup of rice.
This is one good chicken.
And the pies. Oh my gosh, that was one delicious pecan pie.
When you go on a food crawl with Margarita Forés, expect the unexpected.
It's a neighborhood dive, but with a global following. And it also happens to be one of the best places for pizza in New York.
After fried chicken, we're now doing pizza in Brooklyn at Roberta's. And this is so exciting. We're starting with nduya.
Nduya on char-grilled bread is divine.
It's like a spread, it's a soft sausage. Yeah.
Okay.
Yum.
Bread is so good. It's alive. It resonates in your mouth.
And so is Roberta's famous original. A few good ingredients, tomato, mozzarella, caciocavallo, oregano and chili in a gooey, crunchy, charred crust.
Oh.
Right. The dough is great.
The crust. Just the right amount of topping.
The cheese is good.
Yeah, super.
The moment you walk in, the first thing you see are just all these plaques of awards and recognition.
Yeah.
You know, 30 years in a row, they've been high on the list.
Peter Luger is the legendary old-school American steakhouse that's been around since 1887. And tonight, the gang's all here. Edu and I have been eating all day, so we called in some reinforcements. Edu's kids, Addie and Enzo's friend Nicole, are here to help us finish off some steaks.
Two things to remember when dining at Peter Luger. One, make a reservation. Two, they only accept cash, so be sure to bring a bundle.
At Peter Luger, what you're getting is a USDA prime steak, dry-aged and butchered in-house and served sizzling hot, oozing in clarified butter and its own juices. Of course, you must do starters and side dishes as well. Definitely the tomatoes with onion, some bacon, yes, bacon before steak. And with a steak, creamed spinach and onion rings.
But I may have taken a medium well, but I haven't lost anything. It's no. Still so tasty. No, the taste is there.
The taste is definitely there.
Cheers.
Only just begun.
We couldn't possibly do the crawl in New York without passing by that Filipino restaurant that made it to Esquire's 20 best restaurants in all of America.
Yes, and the restaurant's name is Carinderia, and it put the little town of Nyack, New York on the culinary map.
Been one roller coaster ride after another for partners Paula Mendoza and Cheryl Baun, the couple behind Carinderia. It began with a video that the couple made for Kickstarter, a fundraising platform for startups.
You know what, Edu? These are the dishes that Esquire wrote about. They made it to the list of best new restaurants in America. Top 20, can you imagine?
In America. It's like falling off the bone. Literally.
No, the best part is all these like nice gelatin parts.
Wow, I can smell it. This
the
is good chili.
The soft bone is like really good. No, and the asim level is like really intense, but nice.
Yung shrimp adobo, I've been seeing a lot of recipes, pero binawasan ko lang ng toyo. So I let the coconut and the vinegar stand out more. And that's the only difference.
There's a nice little lightness of the gata,
no,
but it's
the,
so pronounced.
The prawns are so fresh. It's just like really yummy. And finally, the iconic adobo.
Yung buong pork belly slab, I put it in the oven slow and low and slow. So about like 4 to 5 hours. Yung sauce niya, and I thicken it. So ang ginagawa ko, I sear it off kasi mas masarap pag pork belly pag medyo crispy. And then I put the thickened sauce on top of it.
You guys are amazing, and thank you so much for having us.
Honestly, this adobo is something else.